Hello and welcome. This is Thomas's tarot page. Here's my guest, Jane Arnold. Yay!
Hello.
You were probably waiting for the individual readings for each individual star sign, because you get more out of them because they're longer, obviously. What happened was my computer broke and it couldn't be repaired. It was just so anyway, I sourced a new computer, and then all these updates came in. Took for bloody ever to get that thing going, and so ultimately. By the time I looked at recording anything, we were already in mid-January. And because there's just no way I could edit 12 videos in just 2 weeks, simply because that new computer didn't take my old editing software. So I had to download editing video software. And if you actually see this, then I actually managed to actually do that. Right? So ultimately what I thought was, for the month of February, let's just go back to weekly readings. So there will be four videos, just like in the old days. And now that everything works, in the following months, we will go back to individual readings per star sign. Now, this video is timestamped. So if you think, I don't want to listen to all these star signs, find yours. Problem solved, right? Don't be a child. But you understand this, it's timestamped. So my advice has always been, listen to the overall energy because that affects all of us. And then just find your star sign, right? Mm. It's just hard for you because we're gorgeous. So, you know, it's not easy to go to not want to watch. You know, fun aside, this video is time-stamped. So the overall energy is coming up now before we go into the first star sign, which is Aquarius. It's the star sign we're in. We're looking at the week of February the 1st to the 6th. Let's have a look what we got as energy for the first week of February. This is the overall energy. What we have? We have the jaguar, the caribou, and the turkey. The jaguar is saying to you, I have unique dots. I am unique. So what the first message to all of us is, because the overall energy for everybody for the first week of February is, don't adapt to situations just because it is easier. Be 100% yourself in the first week of February. Don't just please people, if that makes sense. Because what the guides are saying to you is the next animal guard in is the caribou. The caribou is an animal with antlers, which means you're fully protected. Right? Here you go. So every time you have antlers, it's basically a message that you are fully protected. Right? So therefore, it is a weird thing that you actually have to be protected just so you can be yourself. So if this resonates with you, it's time you reflected on who you are actually with or what job you actually have, where you feel if I'm not adapting, you know, I'm not worth anything. So this is about reflecting and about reflection. Ultimately, what the guides are asking you and us to realize is that you are good enough, more than good enough the way you are, and you are fully protected. Your guides are here. For you to actually state that. And the reason why this is important, because the outgoing energy here is the turkey. Now the turkey is one of the most intelligent birds that we have, and obviously one of the most shot and therefore one of the most eaten. So what the turkey denotes is being misunderstood. So what that means is, if you literally just follow, right? So pleasing others, if that makes sense. And then if you felt like it's time I actually expressed myself, by then, people want you to continue doing what you do. So if you are a person that is there for everybody, they become opportunists. That doesn't necessarily, they don't have, necessarily have to be bad people, right? But you cook for me 5 times a week, I let you. So there's that element here. And what the guides are saying is, if you just give, and you're the only person then to take that away, in the first week of February, the other parties wouldn't even want to understand you, which is why the guides are saying is, be absolutely clear. If something doesn't sit right with you, say it, okay? That's the overall energy that we're having. To be fair, it is not as heavy as it sounds, if that makes sense, but they were focusing on it, if that makes sense. So this is our take two here, so I don't even know if I actually told them who you are. Anyway, that's my friend Jane Arnold. She has been on the show probably 7 times now.
Yeah.
Because I'm using new editing software, I have no idea if I can actually put text here. What I will do, the contact page, your Facebook page will be in the description box, so to speak. Anyway, let's go into the first star sign, and we're in the star sign of Aquarius. This is February the 1st to the 6th, 2022.
Okay, so you Aquarians, the cards I've got here are steady progress, new partner, and fresh air. And what I'm feeling with you is that you have been making progress with your life. You have been stepping forward in certain areas of your life, and you have been taking those steps that you need to take. And I feel that life's been feeling pretty okay. It's not been too bad, not brilliant, but not been too bad. However, there is a feeling that you're possibly leaning, or could be leaning on somebody as well at the moment. With the partner, I'm not so much sure it's a new partner, but I just feel that you've been leaning on somebody, not had the courage to take those steps yourself on your own. And I just feel that just sometimes I want you to be brave enough and confident enough to say, I can do this myself. Not always have to lean on somebody, not always have to have a partner to back you up and to be there. You're taking the steps. It's now the next step. It's now the confidence step. Because there's places you need to go, there's new things that need to come in for you as well. You know, there's a fresh air around you that said, if you can do this and you can build this confidence within yourself, that there is new things that are going to come in and come in around you as well. So, you know, just try and take even just the small steps. They will help, and those small steps will get bigger and bigger, just to enable you to make even more progress with your life. And I feel that you will feel better about yourself because you've done it for yourself, rather than having to just have somebody else to help you along the way. Nothing wrong with that when you need it, but just sometimes try and do it for yourself as well.
Okay, and obviously that is quite interesting, because it sort of mirrors the overall energy where we are supposed to be ourselves. That makes sense, right?
Yeah,
so
does, yeah.
Now we're going to the next star sign, which is Pisces, our star sign.
Yes.
So let's see what they have for us and for all the other Pisceans that have a look. Now, remember, the overall energy was to be unique. And this is actually also mirrored in the messages for us Pisceans, because we have the seahorse. We have the mighty Ram, can't pronounce it, the mighty Ram. And then we have the tiger. What the guides are saying is, the incoming energy is the seahorse. There's a sad statistic that literally says that 90% of seahorses in captivity don't make it. Right? If that makes sense. So what that means for all of us in the first week of February 2022 is to realize anything that really isn't for you, or for us Pisceans, anything that really feels, and this is what I'm getting, I've been in this so long, it became a habit. And all the guides are saying is actually not good enough, because your energy will go lower, and you could also develop quite some issues yourself by staying somewhere that has sort of, is past its end of date thing kind of stuff, right? So that's what I'm getting. So that's number one, where they're saying is, it is the moment. And also Pisceans, we are governed by Neptune. Neptune's job is to bring spiritual awareness. That's why we're the sign of dreamers, if that makes sense. What that means is, while we can be loud and strong and all these kind of things, we're not really super good with stress. As a sign, Pisces, we're not perfect with stress. We like harmony. And that's why when the seahorse comes in the beginning and says, if you are in captivity, if you are somewhere where you feel this isn't for me, don't prolong it. Because, and this is the powerful bit here, you have the Ram in the middle. Let me just show you this depiction here. Right? So you have the Ram. And what the Ram is saying, I will get up that hill. And once I'm up there, I hang on the cliff on two legs and don't fall. Right? So if you make changes to, literally, if you free yourself a little bit, from, and this is not just relationships, could be work, right? But from anything where you feel, I don't really want to be there, you will get up that hill, right? So the changes you need to make are not the end of anything. you will get up that hill, because the outgoing energy is the Tiger. And the Tiger is saying, well, this is certainly a journey. So doesn't feel simple, right? You leave a position, you leave a partner, you're making changes. Obviously, you will have to grieve this out. And then obviously the partner and the job will have something to say about that, if that makes sense. But the Tiger is saying to you, as the outgoing energy, if I lived where the lion lives, the lion wouldn't be the king of the jungle. In other words, it's the stamina that we have. We get through stuff, right? And also, you know, we are obviously represented by Neptune, which was the god of the sea, right? And if anyone can make waves that fucking kill you, right? We'll survive everything. We'll be fine. But you need to understand, if you make changes, the reason why they're difficult is because you waited so long, right? So what they're saying to you is, and if this only half resonates with you, really what I'm getting is, for us Pisceans, is to reflect on, where am I in life? If I set back a little, do I really want that life? Is that really fulfilling me? Would I advise my best friend to live the life I have? And then just be brave enough, because what I'm getting here with the seahorse, seahorse follows for quite some time, and sometimes you hope that situation changes, or you kind of go like, oh, I'm at a certain age, I don't want to go out of the trouble. It's your choice. But if you value your happiness and your highest energy, if this resonates with you at all, what I'm getting is, because 90% of seahorses don't make it in captivity, it is time to make changes that are huge. Mm-hmm. Okay? Pisceans, that was us, right?
Big change.
Big change. If you so choose, right? So you're looking at the week of February the 1st to the 6th. Like I said, there will be weekly readings this month because of computer issues. We only started recording mid-month. Doesn't give me enough time to record the individual episodes as normal. Anyway, that was Pisces going into Aries.
Okay. Aries, you have the Owl, playing and celebrations. This is all about movement, transition, change, and all being good and all being positive. Movement, transition, and changes for you, Aries. It's really, really good, actually. What I'm feeling with this is journeys that you've been wanting to take, longing to take, it actually comes a little bit on the back of yours, doesn't it?
Mm, yeah.
That you've been longing to take, wanting to take. Now it's the time to get on with this change, to get on with this movement. It's very much bringing all those things into your life that you've been wanting to bring into your life. It's movement, it's fast paced. I don't feel small changes with you. I feel big, brave, bold. That's where I feel with the Aries. Not like the Aquarians. It's sort of small change. Yeah. This is just go for it. This big leaps, big bounds.
And you can see, because that also happened to Pisces. So yes. Apparently, in the first week of February, when the energy of February comes in, obviously it's about making changes that can be felt, because obviously it's important. Yeah.
And I can't change the cards.
No, of course not.
It isn't that we're following on. The cards are there, aren't they?
Absolutely.
But with this, there's no holding back. The celebrations are here, talking about bring the new and exciting things into your life. It's a champagne bottle. It's, you know, it's amazing. So all these changes, this is quite short, quite sweet. It's just bring the changes in. It's just like celebrations for the new year, but you're going to bring them in now. The time is now. Absolutely great changes for you. Lovely.
Okay, that was Aries going to the next star sign, which is Taurus. And you have the bobcat, the bald eagle, and the great horned owl. Now, all these three animals denote one thing that is similar, and that means if you have a vantage point, if you just detach yourself a little and look at what's going on, right? Opportunities this month, February, are actually coming to you, Taurians. You don't have to do all that much, because you have the bald eagle in the middle, which means I can see my food from a mile away. So I can see new beginnings, new opportunities also from a mile away. Mm-hmm. And the bobcat, as the incoming energy, is an animal that says, I need a vantage point. All they're saying is it's time to reflect. Again, the reflection we have a lot, like, you know, see if there's change. In your case, they're not asking you to necessarily do massive change, but to have a look and manifest new beginnings, if that makes sense. Because you have the Great Horned Owl as the outgoing energy. And the owl draws an auditory map so she can catch the mouse in the undergrowth without getting caught herself. So since you see opportunities and then you just go for whatever it is you want to go to and you want to go for, you will just be fine. So there's nothing here for Taurians at all. There's in any shape or form negative. All they're saying to you is don't make the mistake to just bump about and just not reflect. Because this is about reflection, because when you have the bobcat coming in saying, well, I need a vantage point, then obviously there are certain things that need to be looked at. Taurians, that was that. Going to the next star sign, which is Gemini. Here we go.
Okay. Gemini, you have child. Cleanse and detoxify, and there's nothing to worry about. The first thing that I'm feeling with Gemini, it's about nurturing yourself, nurturing the child within, looking after yourself. I feel that you've neglected yourself for a while. You've been looking after everybody else. You've been looking about people around you, probably family members, partners, children. But this is about you now looking at yourself, looking inwards a little bit. How can I look after myself better? What do I need to do? Possibly diet as well needs looking at with the cleanse and detoxify. It's about diet, about putting good food into your body, not the rubbish that we've all been putting in there. So I don't know whether you've started diets January or whether you've been putting them off like me. So now would be the time to start looking at healthy ways, even if it's not dieting. Healthy ways to get your body feeling better so you'll feel better. A little bit of exercise, a little bit of good food, because you're not feeling good in yourself. That's the feeling I get with this. I'm not feeling right. I'm not, my mojo's not there. It isn't that there's any, I'm not a doctor, so I can only go by what I feel, but I don't feel that there's anything, you know, real going on with you medically. Some of you, if there is, you go and see your doctor. I feel this is just more so that you've neglected yourself for so long. You're just feeling a little bit rubbish within yourself. And if you do this and you look at yourself and look at what your needs are just for a little while and get yourself feeling better, that you will actually then be in a better place for others. But you're not really in that place yourself to look after others now. So just turn that around a little bit, nurture yourself, and you'll get yourself back on track again.
Okay, that was Gemini. Going to the next star sign, which is Cancer, Cancerians. So Cancer, you have quite good, bit easy or easier animal guides here. You have the Wolverine, the Mountain Goat, and the Lynx. Number one, don't be so hard on yourself. That's the first message that I get for Cancerians, because you're still evolving, right? And while you are evolving, while we are all work in progress, while you are a work in progress, you're nonetheless perfect the way you are, and you also are a full being at any given moment. So what I'm hearing is to not allow anyone to judge you, if that makes sense, right? Because it's so easy to judge, and a lot of people do. Since Cancerians, you are governed by the moon, which is all about emotions. Anyone judges you, you will have problems letting that go. So remember that, right? If you understand, you know what, I'm still learning and I have the right to go at my own pace. Another really important thing for Cancerians, because the middle animal guide, most important one therefore, is the Mountain Goat. And the Mountain Goat is saying, it's a bit like the ram, but the Mountain Goat is already at the top of the mountain. So what the Mountain Goat is saying, I live up here, right? I'm on top of the mountain. I'm the king of the mountain. So what they're saying is to you, if you just understand, you know, you may be a work in progress, but you're already at a point where they're not asking you to make all that much, that many changes to yourself. I think what needs to happen, because you have the Lynx as the outgoing energy, and the Mountain Goat, obviously on top of the mountain, can just watch what to do next. And that's what I'm getting for you, right? Allow yourself to go at your own pace. But maybe if you feel a bit trapped, if you feel like it's not really working, again, reflect and really move on. It seems to be quite a bit of a topic here for this week, because the outgoing energy is the Lynx. And the Lynx is another big cat that basically looks for a vantage point to then assess what's for dinner, if that makes sense. And so what they're saying is, if you have a look where you actually want to go, be honest with yourself, right? It's not the most important thing at this point in time to kind of go like, how am I supposed to get there? Which is also the way you would talk is not great. You have to always go like, I get this. This is what I want to do, so I make it happen, right? When you are using positive affirmations, it is much easier to manifest, if that makes sense. But what I'm getting with Cancerians, and this is probably because your depiction is a crab, and if you give chances to the grab, all the grab is doing like, I'm gonna hide here in crevices, I'm not looking at this. They're asking you to look at stuff. They're asking you to go like, yeah, that's not really me. And then allow yourself to make changes, right? But because yes, the Lynx is the outgoing energy, they're asking you, just look at where is it you really want to go, regardless of circumstances. Because circumstances can change. And if you look at your finances, you go, well, I haven't got the money. If you say you haven't got the money, that's what you just said and what you manifested. If you want to make changes, you literally have to say, and I will make changes. And you could say to your guides, help me, and I work as hard as I have to. You know, reach out, really, really important. Only downside with Cancerians that I'm getting energetically here is that sometimes you're not consistent in asking for guidance, and therefore, because you have free will, you get none, right? So be more outspoken about stuff, okay? That was Cancerians. Next star sign is the mighty Leo.
Okay,
let's have a look
for you lions.
Oh, and by the way, please like, subscribe, and share. And if you like my work, you can now buy me a coffee on buymeacoffee.com/mediumthomas. That's buymeacoffee.com/mediumthomas. Yeah, okay, plugging is over.
Okay, so
now this is Leo.
We have coffin, birth, and luck. Can you imagine those two?
Yeah
great, isn't it? So it just the theme, I love it when we have a beginning theme and it flows all through.
Yeah.
So the coffin really is all about natural endings. I'm not saying about deaths. It's natural endings. And when something ends, you always have to have a new beginning. Something stops, something starts, and then that's your birth card, new beginning. So it's lovely that you've actually got the two there. So and then you have the luck card at the end. So there's a real big energy leap at the end of this. So this is it really is what it says. There's things that need to end, there's things that you need to let go of, there's things that pass a sell by date. So it is a little bit of looking at your life, things that you're not happy with, assessing your life. It's Leo, it's you being brave now. It's you getting there now and saying, okay, sweep this out, because I want the new things to come in. I want the new possibilities here, the new energy to come in. And if you do this, that's exactly what will happen. You know, it's your choice. You can sit and stay with what it is that you've got now. But if you're not happy, it's time to move on. It's time to make the changes. These could be within work. These can be personal changes. These can even be friendships as well. Friendships that are from the course. And the lovely one at the end is the luck card. So again, this is all about luck, about opportunities coming your way. This is saying you're right to be strong and optimistic. So if you're brave enough to go with all these changes, there are some fabulous opportunities that are coming your way as well. So out of the old, in with the new. And yeah, it's real positive and the energy really goes up for me. So really, really good.
Okie dokie, that was Leo's. Going into the next star sign, which is Virgo, we're looking at the week of February the 1st to February the 6th, 2022. Virgos, remember that your depiction is the maiden, but Virgo is quite a strong sign because it is a sign that is a doer, and therefore you don't really need anyone, if that makes sense. And as a sign, Virgo is a sign, for the most part, that actually Virgos don't give in to pressure easily. They're quite, you're more resourceful than you probably give yourself credit for. And how, what you have is you have the Shaman of Foresight, the Ancestor of Tribes, and the Shaman of Courage. The Shaman of Foresight is literally, as the new month starts, the guides are saying to you is, you already know what you must do. You have seen where things are going. Use your intuition and trust your intuition to make changes, because you have the Ancestor of Tribes. And that means that you are obviously an old soul, you have a lot of spiritual guides around you, and you have all the knowledge and wisdom of what came before you. Use the knowledge that you have gotten through a lot of bad situations and are still here and are doing well. Because you have the Ancestor of Tribes, and this might, obviously that's not for everybody, but what I'm getting here, just to say that as a little extra, is if you are one of those Virgos that feels a bit held back because of family issues that happened in the past, because you have the Ancestor of Tribes, maybe you should also look into ancestral healing. Right? Go deeper, if that makes sense. Ultimately, because they're saying to you, you already know what you need to do, you have the Shaman of Foresight, you know where things are going. The outgoing energy is the Shaman of Courage. So what they're saying to you is, you know, have the courage, and this is what I'm getting, to walk away from whatever it is that really isn't for you. And just trust that your tribe, your tribes are around you. It's also important in that sense, because when you talk about tribes, maybe you haven't found your tribe. Maybe you are deeper than you think. Maybe you are with people that are not as deep as you. And maybe you just have to hang out with more spiritual people. Actually talk about, let's meditate, let's do all this, let's do a ritual, let's hug a tree, all these kind of things that are quite deep. Remember, you have the Ancestor of Tribes in the middle. It is important for you to have people where that you can be completely free around, if that makes sense, right? So that was what we got for Virgos. Now we're going into the star sign that really loves harmony, which is Libra.
Yeah. Okay, Libra, you have cleanse and detoxify child and shower of abundance. What I'm feeling with you is there's a sensitivity that's going on around you at the moment. I feel you're more sensitive than normal. You do like balance, you do like things to be. And when things are out of balance, that's when you become more sensitive, more edgy. You don't like it. It doesn't flow with you nicely. And I feel at the moment that's where you're at. I feel that things are out of balance for you a little bit. And you need to look at this and you need to address this, because it doesn't feel right. And when things don't feel right for you, life doesn't feel right. And then it has like a snowball effect. So I feel that it's shedding. I keep getting shedding old ways. So there's something that's going on there. Releasing, shedding, letting go. It's all part of that. And I know that we've said that a few times in these readings, but it just seems to be a constant thing that's going through all these readings. There's development that's coming with you. There's growth that's coming with you. So this imbalance that you have at the moment that's making you feel out of sorts is a necessary imbalance. And then once you've moved with this and you've shed these old ways and old things that need to go, there's a lot of abundance that is then coming in for you. Now, abundance, it can come financially, which is great, but also abundance comes in more ways than one. And I just feel that this abundance that's coming in for you, and I'm not so sure it's financial, but it could be in certain situations. But I feel that you're going to become more creative within your life. There's things that you can create, things that you can build. And I feel that's where the growth is going to be. This can be personal as well as in your life as well. But it is important for you to look and address this imbalance first, so then you can bring the improvements in.
Okay, if you could see me smirk here, it's just because I had a thought. I wasn't trying to be rude to Libras. Here's my thought, because I have problems with my voice today. Now we're doing Scorpio, and then we have Sagittarius and Capricorn left.
Mm-hmm.
And I will ask Jane to do both star signs. And I just keep quiet. Here we go. So that's sorted then, right? I hear no objections, do you? Fine. So that's what made me crack up in my mind. Anyway, here's Scorpio. Here we go. You have the panther, the frog, and the red-tailed hawk. Ultimately, this is all about you realizing in your life, right now, Scorpios, you do not have to overreact, because the Scorpio, you know, the larger the Scorpio, the less venom, the scorpion, the less venom it has. So, you know, if you stand tall, you will have to be less lethal. But you have these options where you sometimes don't know which one am I today, if that makes sense. Ultimately, what the guides are saying is you have the panther, the frog, and the red-tailed hawk. The panther is saying, right, the less you show who you are, the more your unique dots are hidden inside the panther, the more vulnerable you actually will be, because when you look at the panther, which means there is a leopard inside the panther, and the panther by default has a very dark collar, like dark fur, which means in nature a panther stands out much more than the jaguar or the leopard ever would. So by you hiding how you truly feel, just to not get in trouble, because there's nothing I'm getting this week for Scorpios, don't even have the thought of getting in trouble, right? But don't hide any longer, because you have the panther as the first animal. Don't hide. And the reason why I'm saying this is because your middle card, the one that is surrounded by two other animal guides and therefore becomes the most important, is bloody awesome. Because you have the frog. And the frog is saying, you're an amphibian. You can live on land and on water. If people don't like you the way you are, fuck them. Right? Sorry, I needed to swear every now and then. No, but you understand that what I'm hearing is to not, again and again and again, that's what I'm getting with Scorpio, because the way they show it to me is the Scorpio is getting smaller and larger, and you just don't know where you want to go. And all the guides are saying is, if push comes to shove, and there has to be changes, and there will be changes, you will be safe. You can live anywhere, you can do anything, you just have to start believing it and make the first step. I also feel for some of you that are on the verge of leaving a situation, you will very likely, this is the way they show it to me, find that people you haven't even counted on will open their hearts and say, like, well, you could keep a night here, you know, if that makes sense. So what they're asking you to do is to not just despair, because it doesn't aid you, right? Because the outgoing energy is the hawk. And now this is important. While the frog is saying to you, you can do whatever you want and you will be safe, right? And the hawk is using the upthrust of the air to glide. So what they're saying is, try to stay calm, which is also important, because it is confusing, because to a certain extent, if you're not calm, you have less venom, right? Being depicted by the scorpion. But this goes deeper. This is about saying, you know, even if you left a situation or you left something behind, doesn't have to be a relationship, could also be work, or could be anything where you feel like, I just have outgrown that, if that makes sense. Just go with the flow. New things will happen. And also look at it logically. I have no idea how old you are, right? But so far, obviously you're still around.
Yeah.
Right? So whatever happened to you in your life, you're still around. And because if it was traumatic and you have gone through it, right, there's less stuff that needs to be triggered. And so understanding that you have already been through a lot and that you are now a different person should highlight for you that you will not manifest the same crap. Really another important thing to just realize who you truly are and how much progress you have made is more than half the rent, if that makes sense. Outgoing energy, like I said, is the hawk. Really powerful bird of prey. But it uses the upthrust of the air to glide, right? So it's pointless having the same arguments over and over again. Just make the changes you need to make and let things happen and develop naturally. Okay, that was Scorpio. Now we have in Sagittarius and Capricorn left, and Jane kindly agreed to do the two star signs.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Oh,
look at those two.
Oh, wow. Oh, they're beautiful, actually.
Lovely, aren't they? They're good, but they are what they are.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So, Sagittarius, you have Phoenix, fire, and love. And the Phoenix, it's the old tale. The Phoenix rises from the ashes. And obviously, you have the fire as well. So that's what I was saying to Thomas. You know, look at those two together. So, it's all about renewal, refresh, renew. It says from period to crisis, but I'm not so sure it's the crisis. I just feel it's a renewal of you. That's what I feel. I feel it's you coming back. It's you bounding back, because the fire, the two fire elements, you know, quite fiery. So this is going to be with a force. This is, you're not a shrinking violet. You're coming back with a force. You're coming forward about something. And this is more about, I feel, emotional upheavals, it says, with the fire. And I do feel this is you stand in your corner, fighting your fight, coming back from some things. So I feel, you know, you've possibly held yourself back, bitten your tongue, waited, bided your time, but now you're actually coming back to the fore. And things that need to be said will be said, because I can feel my throat's been closing. So it's like you've not been standing up for yourself. So now the energy is there. The fire is bringing the energy here for this. And then you have the love card, and there's lots of lovely hearts and everything on this card. But this, for me, it's more about positivity. It's more about bringing in that element back into your life. So this may well be a love connection for some of you that have held back, that have not said, that need to get your points of view over. You know, some of it will be love connections, because I'm really drawn to the roses. So I do feel some of you, it is going to go in that direction. But for others, this is about loving yourself now. It's, you know, burning, getting rid of all those old stagnant feelings, thoughts, things that have been going on, and loving yourself now enough to want to do this. Real powerful energy, those two fire elements in that. I love that. Real powerful.
And remember, now we're going into Capricorn, last star summit, but remember that 2022, just the number 2 and 2 and 2 is 6. 6 is a much stronger number than 5. 2021 was 5, which means the year of change. Now you have number 3, which is the number of, can't even speak, you know, number of progression. Then you have the number 9, which is the number of completion. And then you have 6 in the middle, which means you have already a year where anything you want to change, anywhere you want to progress, is much more likely to actually happen, because the energy is literally better. So don't pay all that much attention to people messing it up by being by living in fear and paying too much attention to the bloody telly and all that kind of stuff that comes. Life is, to a large extent, what we make it, if that makes sense, right? And if you are in yourself saying, yeah, life is good and I can make this happen, and I make this happen even if there is a bloody lockdown, and even if I have to wear a bloody mask, right? Don't judge others, you know, just be in yourself, because the energy of 2022 is an energy we really, really needed, because last year just wasn't a year for many people to actually get stuff really done.
Yeah.
And that's what happens when you have the number 5 as the informing energy of an entire year, where they're saying, well, there's too many changes, so, you know, it's hard to plan. This 2022 is a much better place. And then you have February 2022, if that makes sense. So you have another number 2 in there. So it's quite powerful. It's also important because number 2 is, oftentimes the Roman numeral for 2, which is actually in many ways related to Gemini, to the energy of Gemini. Therefore, it's important for all of us to realize, you know, not going things alone is important. So February feels, energetically speaking, quite powerful. Anyway, that was my monologue. No idea where this came from. Right? And now we're going to the last star sign for the first week of February, February the 1st to the 6th. This is Thomas's tarot page. This is my friend Jane Arnold. Thank you so much for being here. Yeah. Right? And please like, subscribe, and share. Really important, right? Capricorn, it is.
Okay, you have release and surrender, listen and notice the signs. Now, with this, this is challenges again. Life's been quite challenging. I feel there's quite a heavy energy when I go into the Capricorn energy. And life has been challenging. And I feel a lot of personal situations have been very, very challenging. And I want to go back into the tail end of last year for this. I'm going back the last 2-3 months of challenges for you. And I feel that it's been a difficult time and you've not really known which way to go. That's how I feel with this. I feel it's been, you've been thrown off course, thrown out of balance. You've not known which way to go, how to go with things. And I need to say to you that don't worry, because you've been protected, because you've had the angel wings around you. It says listen. So it's also, we need to listen to our own intuition. We need to listen what we're being told, what our guides are trying to help us and our ancestors are trying to help us to move forward with certain situations. But the angel wings around that lady are beautiful. It's saying you've been protected, you've been looked after through all this period of time. And we've always been there with you. You've not been alone, because there's a feeling of loneliness through all this. And I know the way I'm feeling with this, it's been a real difficult time for you. So understand that you have help and you still have help and have support. And it's like the next phase now is coming. Notice the signs. So it's very much my spiritual card. This is when it comes up in a reading. So it can mean literally what it is, that, you know, just be aware of spiritual signs around you, being aware that they're trying to tell you, you know, when the cup that was there is now moved, the car keys have disappeared and they come back, little signs that will be all around you. But it's just their way of reminding you and saying, you are loved, you are protected, we are helping you with the next phase. So just be aware of that. And also notice the signs of change I'm seeing as well. There are signs of change that are coming. They may look small at the moment, but hold on to those, because they are taking you forward now as well. So it's a better period of time you're coming into.
Okay, thank you so much. That was Thomas's tarot page. That's all we have for the first week of February, which was February the 1st to the 6th. Thank you so much for understanding that due to technical issues, I started recording very late. So there will only be 4 videos and they will be for all the star signs. We will change back to the longer, more in-depth videos, but you know, I only work here. I cannot change when change what happens with technology and all that kind of stuff, right? And if it's not meant to happen, it wasn't meant to happen. There's nothing I could have done, right? I think I sourced it quite quickly, actually, to be fair, you know. So yeah, glad you're still with us, if that makes sense. Haven't given up on us, and yeah, the other format will be resumed in the new months, but there will be another video for the following week. Jane, thank you so much.
Thank you. Right? Enjoyed
and
it.
Thank you all for watching, and share or I'll hunt you down. Always wanted to try that. I have a set of skills. No, anyway, yeah, but if you actually share, the more people are watching it, yeah, that's when the YouTube algorithm actually understands that the video is there, and that's when we can share, because what we're doing here for free is the idea is to say, like, if we can reach more people and give them more free guidance, why wouldn't we? And I need you to share. A lot of people have said that to me. They watch it, they love it, I get super comments. And then I was like, why haven't you shared it? Oh, I didn't think about it. So I know they're not doing this out of spite. It's just it doesn't occur to them.
Yeah.
And I need you to get this sort of into your mind, that the more you share the videos, ultimately the more people are viewing the videos every week, the more the channel can grow, which is really what we want, right? Okie dokie, guys. See you soon. Bye bye.